Stiles, Mystery Diners.
Have you and your friends ever gone into a fight about which TV food personality was the best? Maybe it was the GOAT, Gordon Ramsay, without a doubt the pioneer of reality cooking. Or what about Jamie Oliver, one of the most recognizable family television cooks of all time? Or how about John Taffer and his creative approach to solving America's bars? Well, forget about all your wrong opinions and let me introduce you to
Charles Stiles, Mystery Diners.
Mystery Diners was Food Network's attempt to cash in on the craze that was reality restaurant TV. Mostly Fox's wildly successful show, Kitchen Nightmares, starring two kids in a chef's jacket.
You're not a f***ing chef! High, bright, golden, yeah, making nice, simple beef Wellington.
Now, Mystery Diners, by all accounts, must have been successful because it had 11 seasons with 142 different episodes. Now, is that because Food Network will air anything semi-related to food that can hold a viewer's attention for more than 10 minutes? Probably. Or do they just need a filler show to put between the 23-hour straight of Chopped?
Another lazy man's recipe.
Now, for those of you who don't know when it's done, you see how there's little touches of brown? Let me just tip this up a little bit here.
But what exactly is Mystery Diners, though? Well, starring this 80s-looking porn star and his squad of Mystery Diners, usually consisting of whoever's on set that day, with the only consistent characters being Charles and his daughter, who are then hired by restaurants to solve their problems. Pretty simple, right?
Lately, I've been hearing from the songwriters that they feel like the contest could be rigged.
Wait a second, he's got a backpack and tong. That's so bizarre.
He's taking the lobster.
That is a bold-faced lie. I personally inspected that comic book, and I know that it's an original and it's in pristine condition.
Even more concerning, I found no record of Yanni or Bella ever having even lived in Russia. I checked every record and I checked every census in Russia, and Yanni and Bella just don't seem to exist.
Why he's treating you so bad? He's wanting you to quit because they're having an affair.
What?
Oh my God. Really?
The problems are wacky and insane. I might even go as far to describe them as downright goofy. The plot for every Mystery Diners episode is the exact carbon copy, except you change the location and the conflict. If you ever wondered what having dementia was like, try watching an entire season of this show. But every episode of Mystery Diners will follow the same four mysterious plot progressions. See what I did there? It's in the consultation that Charles greets the owner with his signature catchphrase.
Charles Stiles, Mystery Diner. Charles Stiles, Mystery Diners. Charles Stiles, Mystery Diner. Charles Stiles, Mystery Diners. 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 Charles Stiles, Mystery Diners.
Charles Stiles, Mystery Diners. How are you?
You can't convince me Charles isn't a robot programmed by Food Network, but it's in this segment that we learn about the problems the Mystery Diners are going to face. The odd thing, though, is the conflict that the owners bring up is exactly what the Mystery Diners are going to face, completely ruining the entire undercover premise of the show. Like, imagine watching Scooby-Doo, but there's only one culprit ever. Oh, and don't forget about the 30-second advertisement worse than your favorite YouTuber shilling out a NordVPN sponsorship. I love NordVPN! While Charles and his team is planting 50 million cameras around the restaurant.
Cameras have been hidden at key locations throughout Newport Beach Brewing Company. Cameras 1 and 2 have been set up in the main dining room to give an overall perspective of the restaurant and its customers. Camera 3 has been set up by the bar. Cameras 4 and 5 have been set up in the brewery. Camera 6 has been set up in the kitchen. And cameras 7, 8, and 9 have been set up in the parking lot. 1 and 2 have been set up in the main dining room to give an overall perspective of the restaurant and its customers. Cameras 3 and 4 have been set up in the bar. Cameras 5 and 6 have been set up in the kitchen. Camera 7 has been set up in the waiter station. And camera 8 has been set up in the parking lot, set up by the main entrance. Cameras 3, 4, and 5 have been set up in the main dining room. Cameras 6 and 7 have been set up in the kitchen. And cameras 8 and 9 have been set up in the dining room to give an overall perspective of the restaurant and its customers. Cameras 4 and 5 have been set up in the kitchen. Cameras 6 and 7 have been set up in the waiter station. And cameras 8 and 9 have been set up in the dining room to give an overall perspective of the restaurant and its customers. 3 cameras have been set up in the bar. 2 cameras have been set up in the kitchen. And 2 cameras have been set up on the patio, to track any action that happens outside.
County man's behind bars after planting a hidden camera inside of the home of a D.C. family.
The sting is when things really start to heat up in the show. Charles and the owner will spend majority of the episode in what they call
the control room.
That's decked out with only the most sophisticated in spying devices, such as microphone, TV, large pictures, restaurant layout. Charles in his control room is the equivalent of Gordon Ramsay just sitting in the dining room or John Taffer in his black Escalade. Except there's one problem. The control room doesn't actually do anything. I think it's just a room where the owner and Charles have a bit of banter, react to some pre-recorded footage to ham up the reality of the show. I'd also be willing to bet all 326 of my subscribers' lives that Charles' desk mic isn't hooked up to a Mystery Diner's earpiece like their Secret Service.
This place down, we're gonna play tonight.
Lori, try to get in the poker game.
I would love to play.
Okay.
Well, at precisely the 17-minute mark of every episode, the owner will confront the offender back in the sting room where John introduces himself again for some reason.
Bess, my name's Charles Stiles. I'm with a company called Mystery Diners.
But it's during this confrontation, Charles gets to flex his acting chops and shows why he has a show with 10 seasons.
And the Oscar goes to...
Charles Stiles.
You're giving away free shots. You're picking up on these girls. You're having them take their bras off for free drinks.
The update section's like the last minute of like the entire show. It's just like the narrator saying that John saved the day and there's no more problems. That's it. Like we're in the mid-roll of the video, right? Like no comedy here. All right, I don't got time to be funny in the mid-roll of the video. Okay, you're gonna click through here anyway. You're not even watching this. So like. Just keep on clicking. Nothing here. Just keep clicking. Get to the next part. There's some cool shit coming up. Like, don't even worry about it right now. Like, this shit isn't even funny. Why are you watching this? Stop. You're not even watching this. Stop it.
Subscribe.
You must be asking yourself, Dante, why are you telling me this? Well, it's because I selected an episode of Mystery Diners to watch, and I felt like it was important that you understood that every episode is going to be the same. Just replace the conflict with an equally crazier conflict, and boom, you got a brand new episode of Mystery Diners. To properly review an episode of Mystery Diners, I'm gonna have to become a Mystery Diner myself. So I turned my bedroom into an exact replica of the control room, featuring monitors, desk microphone, massive headshots, generic floor layout. From this control room, I can now properly observe Charles observing Mystery Diners, observing regular diners, by you guys observing me at home.
Hi, Johnny.
Hi, welcome to Peanut Pizza.
How are you?
Good,
Charles,
how are you?
Stiles, Mystery Diners.
Charles, nice to meet you.
Great.
I'm
this
Johnny.
This is Grant. He's one of our Mystery Diners.
Grant, nice to meet you. Come on around, you guys.
Charles, you don't need to introduce yourself every time in the company like that. Johnny knows who you are. He hired your company. He certainly knows who you are at this point. Who is this introduction for? Then again, Charles is the one with 11 seasons on TV, so maybe I need to change my introduction. Dante Unknowns, unemployed, I mean content creator.
Tickets that are voided with pizzas on them, and I don't see the pizzas. Usually when a pizza's made wrong or something, it ends up in the refrigerator, and my beer profit has gone down by $200-$300 a month, which a couple beers here, a couple pizzas there, doesn't seem like a lot, but for a small mom-and-pop operation like ours, it adds up over the year, and it could be devastating to us.
Absolutely.
Yeah. So is there anybody in particular that you're concerned about? You know, I do have a lot of college guys here working, and college kids aren't going to take a part-time job very serious, and it could be any one of them, but my main suspect is Jed. When his shift's on, I notice I come in the morning, there's, you know, empty beer bottles in the walk-in. The kitchen's telling me, oh, he makes mistakes. I just really like him, but I don't want to suspect him, but I do suspect him.
All right, that's a lot to unpack. Okay, so dough is missing, and beer sales are down, and Johnny suspects Jed. Have you considered asking him? Maybe ask, like, any of your employees before calling Charles Stiles to set up a million cameras. And what is the deal with all these jump cuts? It's not like a complex scene, it's really just Johnny and Charles having a conversation. Why do we have 21 jump cuts in, like, a minute? I don't know, maybe step back, take a wide shot? I'm getting, like, a seizure from watching this.
Overall perspective of the restaurant and its customers. Cameras 3 and 4 have been set up in the kitchen. Camera 5 has been set up by the front entrance. And camera 6 has been set up in the parking lot to track any action outside. In addition to Grant, who will be going undercover as a busboy in training, Mystery Diner Jill will pose as a flirtatious sorority.
All right, everyone, for your roles today, Grant, you'll be going undercover as a busboy, all right? Wash some dishes. And Jill, you will be playing a whore. All right, you got that? She really drew the short stick on the roles here.
Control room, as you can see, we've got everything set up here, as we talked about.
You know, this is fantastic. This is just what I needed.
All right, well, you know what? Let's get started on this day.
Okay, great.
So that's Jed, I take it.
Yeah.
Johnny, I know it could be hard being a small business owner, but you don't got to do this. You could still back out. You don't need Charles Stiles here, all right? Like, I looked up the law on Yahoo, and it says right here you could fire Jeb for anything. Like, we can just cut these cameras right now and just save a lot of time.
Really cool. He's the man. I mean, I wouldn't work anywhere else, really, to be honest.
They just said you're a pretty cool boss.
Well, I am. I like to be a cool boss.
It's one thing to be seen as a cool boss, but it's another thing to respect your policies. Hey, Grant, ask Jed about eating on the job.
Dang, man, I'm just
really hungry.
Yeah. Dude, if you want food, yeah, you can just go get some sometimes. Yeah.
Can I just, like, grab some pizza in between tables and stuff?
Yeah, sure.
Really?
I eat leftovers, like, all the time.
That's disgusting. Not cool with me.
I refuse to believe that Charles has a working table mic directly linked to Grant's ear. If so, 326 of you guys are about to die. Also, while eating leftovers is rancid and is really against company policy, if anything, this should clear Jed as a suspect, right? Also, this is just a quick pet peeve of mine. Whenever they have like a gadget with a camera, which they have a million of if you go through all the seasons, like they have this whole, they lower the saturation on it and throw this little camera thing in the corner, and I hate it so much. Like, stop doing this. Like, I can do that too. It's not hard. It's like one button. I press one button and look at this. Oh my god. Look, we're in a camera too. It's cameraception. It's fucking crazy.
Pizza? Pepperoni pizza?
Put the phone down. What the hell's wrong with this guy?
Are you serious? That's not only rude, but it also shows a complete lack of customer service.
Hang on, man. Yeah. Why don't you guys just come in and we'll talk?
Is it rude, Charles? Does it show a complete lack of customer service? The show tries so hard to make Charles out to be this authority in restaurant management, but I'm just not convinced at this point. When Gordon critiques Food and Kitchen Nightmares, it's impactful. I learn something about a topic I'm a lot less versed in. But Charles makes these generic observations, like he's a shitty commentary channel. Wait a minute, hold on.
Waiters helped each other out with drink orders all the time.
He just walked into the cooler with a beer? I guess
it's Miller time.
That needs to go on a shirt. Comment below if you buy a Charles Stiles It's Miller Time shirt.
Fortunately, we didn't have a camera in the freezer, and we need video evidence.
We need to watch it a little bit more, because you need to have enough evidence to make some decisions.
You don't need any more evidence.
Okay, Jill, come on in.
I'll be posing as a sorority girl. My goal is to flirt with Jed and be cute, and hopefully get him to provide services for me that he shouldn't be providing.
Where are you guys coming from?
Coming from school.
Where are you guys
from? Cal State.
Cal State? Long Beach?
Where do you go?
Yeah, I go to Long Beach too.
Nice.
You look familiar.
Yeah.
Just a drink while you're waiting?
I'll have a beer.
A beer? Can I just see you guys' IDs?
Oh my god, I hate you so much, fucking Jill. That's why I gave her trying to stick up for her. No wonder they gave her the weaker of the two roles. A beer? You couldn't ask for anything else? Like, anything specific? Charles even knew a beer. Charles said it's Miller time, so whoever's writing these lines clearly knows what beer is.
Okay, well, how old are you?
21. 21.
Jill, hesitate a little bit when you tell him your birthday.
June 10th of 91.
91?
Yeah.
As you get better at learning your birthdays, you're gonna need those.
Charles Stiles strikes again. I'm just saying, you put Charles Stiles and Sam Bankman-Fried alone in a room with 20 cameras, and he's finding that missing millions in no time.
Hey,
what's
how you doing,
up,
man?
Dude?
Hey, you guys made it. What up?
Hey, man.
Are these regular customers you recognize?
No.
I wonder if that's the guys he was talking to on the phone.
Thank you.
Why is he pouring beer in styrofoam cups instead of a glass?
He's disguising the beer. He's disguising it in styrofoam cups for his buddies.
What a bunch of
I've been keeping it on the down low, right? These are pretty good road sodas.
Jamie, go ahead and pull that back up for me. Freeze frame. Enhance. Aeropostale colored shirt. Dog tags. Cargo shorts. Douchey hat? It can't be. Jamie, instant replay.
Keep it on the down low, right? These are pretty good road sodas.
Oh my god. They're frat guys. A long, long time ago, I too was a frat guy, and I'm honestly impressed on how accurate they managed to get the trope. But if only they had spent as much time as they did writing fratty dialogue, the show might have been good.
So what are you guys up to?
Jill, tell him you need beer for your sorority party tonight.
Our sorority is having a party.
Oh, really?
Yeah. We actually could kind of use some beer.
Yeah? We have about a half a keg left back there.
What the hell?
Yeah, but I do have to charge you a little bit, like $50.
He said he's gonna charge her $50 for the keg of beer. My question is, what's he gonna do with the $50 that he charges her?
I bet your sweet we know what he's gonna do with it.
Can you take 40?
Yeah, 40.
Jed just got done with his Hustlers University. He's breaking the matrix, get a job, steal some alcohol, sell to minors. What can I say? It's 100% profit. Satisfaction guaranteed.
He's doing it in full view of your other employees. Jill,
head out to the parking lot.
Hey.
Hey.
Nice. This is it.
Anytime somebody walks out the back door with booze, I'm in trouble. This isn't a frickin' frat house. It's a business. This is a running restaurant. He is destroying my business.
This is the payoff if you sat through this entire thing. One, why do all the girls and Jeb's friends show up together for the keg? Like, they've never met. They only met Jeb. Also, the way Jeb's friends just run away as soon as Johnny shows up. I don't know what's more realistic, the way they ran away immediately, or how the third guy clearly just did not know what to do and just stood there like a Skyrim NPC.
My name's Charles Stiles. I'm with a company called Mystery Diners.
He said it. You know, if somebody looks under 30 years old, I have to see an ID. I could lose my liquor license and I'll be down $100,000. Are you going to pay me $100,000?
John, you know that's not what I want, obviously.
You use your cell phone. I saw you had it out talking.
You're right. I shouldn't have been on my cell phone, but I was on the phone with customers
The phone.
Whose customers?
Your
frat buddies?
Yeah, and they are regulars now because of me. Because
then
they come in here.
Why the hell did you serve them beer in a cup? You gave away free pizza to your buddies. You gave them free beer with no intention of ever charging them.
Johnny went through a lot.
Oh my god, shut the fuck up, Charles. At this point, give Johnny a show. He's a way better actor.
Me.
Since being fired, Jed and his friends haven't returned. With all of his food and alcohol accounted for, Johnny is no longer losing money, and business is back up at Pina Pizza House.
Wait a minute. What did that just say? The people and events depicted in this program are real? Certain events may have been edited for dramatic purposes? Are you telling me that this was the more dramatic take on events? The only way things could have been less dramatic had Charles been in a coma for 22 minutes. Alright, I got a serious brain bleed at this point from watching too much Mystery Diners, so let's try and get to like 500 subs or something, and I'll do the lobster episode of Mystery Diners. But have a good new year, hope you had a good Christmas, and I am out of here.